Can you hear me? Then today we will discuss some numericals on hydrograph. So I will be discussing problems related to the equations or concepts which are given in the first slide. So first thing, I know everybody is familiar with the flat hydrograph, diachronic hydrograph, and the unit hydrograph concepts. A flat hydrograph, how to get a flat hydrograph? If we have a diachronic hydrograph, we need to add base flow component to the diachronic hydrograph in order to get flat hydrograph. So by solving the problems and all, in the question, flat hydrograph will be given. So we will deduct the base flow component from the flat hydrograph to get the diachronic hydrograph. So if we want to find out ordinate of flat hydrograph, we need to add base flow component to the ordinate of diachronic hydrograph. That is first concept. Then coming to relation between diachronic hydrograph and a unit hydrograph. A unit hydrograph is nothing but a diachronic hydrograph of 1 cm rainfall excess or 1 cm runoff depth. So if we have the ordinate of a diachronic of a unit hydrograph of d hour duration, if we multiply the rainfall excess in centimeter with the ordinate of unit hydrograph, we will get corresponding ordinate of direct runoff hydrograph of same duration d. Then third concept, this is an important equation. The area under a direct runoff hydrograph will give the volume of runoff. The volume of runoff is also equal to product of area of the catchment and the rainfall excess or runoff depth. Then there will be majority of the questions will be based on this third equation. So please remember this formula. Then coming to fourth equation. So in numerical part, I have not concentrated much on S-curve concept. So here one simple equation only I have included. If we have catchment area and the rainfall intensity, the product of catchment area and the rainfall intensity will give the maximum ordinate of an S-curve. So we will see the problems one by one. First question, I will dictate the problem, then you try to solve the question yourself. I will allow 15 to 20 second time. Afterwards, I will discuss the answers. First question, the direct runoff hydrograph of a storm obtained from a catchment is triangular in shape and has a base period of 80 hours. The peak flow rate is 30 meter cube per second and catchment area is 86.4 kilometer square. The rainfall excess that has resulted the above hydrograph is options 5 cm, 8 cm, 10 cm and 16 cm. So just to remember the third equation, area of catchment into rainfall excess equal to volume of runoff, which is also equal to area under direct runoff hydrograph. Try to solve this problem. Okay. In this question, the base period. So the diagram of hydrograph given in the question would be like. Tell me, pardon.
Can I answer that first question? Excuse me,
ma'am.
Yes. The first question answer is the 5 centimeter.
5 centimeter, okay. Here, the direct run of hydrograph given in the question would be like this. The base period is 80 hours and the peak flow rate is 30 meter cube per second. So the area under this direct run of hydrograph will be half BH, which is half into base period 80 hours, and the discharge is given in meter cube per second. So we need to convert this hours into seconds by multiplying with 3600, peak flow 30. That will be equal to area of the catchment, which is given in kilometer square. So we have to convert into meter. Meter square, we need to multiply with 10 power 6. Then the options are given in centimeter, rainfall excess in centimeter. So the unknown parameter is rainfall excess or x in centimeter divided by 100. So the answer will be 5 centimeter. Then we will move to second question. An average rainfall of 16 centimeter occurs over a catchment during a period of 12 hours with a uniform intensity. The unit hydrograph means unit depth 1 centimeter and duration 6 hours of the catchment arises uniformly from 0 to 30 meter cube per second in 6 hours and then falls linearly from 30 to 0 meter cube per second in next 12 hours. The phi index of catchment is known to be 0.5 centimeter per hour. Base flow in the river is known to be 5 meter cube per second. So the first question, the peak discharge of resulting flood hydrograph shall be. Options are 150 meter cube per second, 225 meter cube per second, 230 meter cube per second and 360 meter cube per second. Second question, area of the catchment in hectares. Options 97.2, 270, 9720 and 27000. So, in this question, the data on peak discharge and other ordinates of a unit hydrograph of 6 hour duration is given, and we were asked to find out the peak discharge of a flood hydrograph, which is having a duration of 12 hours. So, from the 6 hour unit hydrograph, we need to find out ordinate of a flood hydrograph of 12 hour duration. Just a second, we will see the answer. So in the question, it is given that the peak discharge of 30 meter cube per second is occurring at a 6 hour and in the next 12 hours, means 6 plus 12, at the 18th hour, it is dropping to 0 meter cube per second. So, for different 6 hour time intervals, the discharge of a unit hydrograph for 6 hour duration is given as 0, 30, 15 and 10. We need to convert this 6 hour unit hydrograph into 12 hour unit hydrograph. For that, we need to lag the ordinates by 6 hour. So here, third column, the discharge values lagged by 6 hour. So it will be starting from 6th hour. So first 0, 30, 15 and 15 and again 0. Then we need to add second and third column to obtain the ordinates corresponding to 12 hour duration and the 2 centimeter rainfall axis, which is nothing but ordinates of a direct runoff hydrograph of 12 hour duration and 2 centimeter rainfall axis. So fourth column is a sum of second and third column. So the ordinates are 0, 30 plus 0, 30, 15 plus 30, 45, 0 plus 15, 15 and 0 meter cube per second. From the 2 centimeter direct runoff hydrograph of 12 hour duration, we can get unit hydrograph of 12 hour duration by dividing the rainfall excess value of direct runoff hydrograph. So here the ordinates has to be divided with the rainfall excess of 2 centimeter to find out ordinate of unit hydrograph. So the ordinates will be 0, 15, 22.5, 7.5 and 0. So now we have the ordinates of 12 hour unit hydrograph. From here we can find out the ordinate of 12 hour direct runoff hydrograph of a particular rainfall excess. So see the question again. Here the rainfall depth is given as 16 centimeter and the base period is 0.5 centimeter per hour. Not base period, the phi index value, and the rainfall is occurring for 12 hours. So this 0.5 into 12 hours, 6 centimeter will be the abstraction losses. So we need to deduct the 6 centimeter from the rainfall depth. So in this question, the rainfall excess will be 10 centimeter. So if we multiply the ordinates of unit hydrograph by this 10 centimeter, we will get ordinates of direct runoff hydrograph of 12 hour duration and 10 centimeter rainfall excess. If we have the peak ordinate of direct runoff hydrograph and the base flow is already given as 30 meter cube per second. If we add the peak discharge plus base flow value, we will get peak discharge of flat hydrograph of 12 hour duration as 230 meter cube per second. And the second question, area of the catchment. This is similar to previous question only. Here area is asked in hectares. So we need to multiply with the 10 power 4. Since it's a unit hydrograph, rainfall excess will be 1 centimeter. So 1 by 100. So this is the area under the unit hydrograph. So the answer is area of the catchment will be 9,720 hectares. Any doubt in this question? Shall I proceed to third question? Okay. The average rainfall for a 3-hour duration storm is 2.7 centimeter, and the loss rate is 0.3 centimeter per hour. The flood hydrograph has a base flow of 20 meter cube per second and produces a peak flow of 210 meter cube per second. The peak flow of 3-hour unit hydrograph is. Options are 125.5 meter cube per second, 105.5 meter cube per second, 77.77 meter cube per second, and 70.37 meter cube per second. This is also a simple question. The duration of the storm is 3 hours, and the flood hydrograph peak and base flow values are given. The peak flow of unit hydrograph is asked in the question. So the answer for the third question is 105.5 meter cube per second. Shall I move to fourth question? Okay, the fourth question. For a catchment, the S curve due to a rainfall of intensity 1 cm per hour is given by Q equal to 1 minus 1 plus T e to the power minus T, where T is in hours and Q is in meter cube per second. What is the area of the catchment? Options: 0.01 km square, 0.36 km square, 1 km square, and 1.28 km square. So in this question, the equation of the S curve is given. So with this equation, the peak ordinate of S curve can be find out by giving the value of T as infinity. And the rainfall intensity is given as 1 centimeter per hour. So, area of the catchment into rainfall intensity is nothing but discharge rate. The answer for fourth question, 0.36 km square. Any doubt? Let's move to fifth question. The ordinates of a 2-hour unit hydrograph at a 1-hour interval starting from T equal to 0 are 0, 3, 8, 6, 3, 2, and 0 meter cube per second. Use trapezoidal rule for numerical integration if required. And the question is to find out the catchment area represented by the unit hydrograph. Options: 1 km square, 2 km square, 7.92 km square, and 8.64 km square. in this question, the shape of the unit hydrograph is not given as triangular. We have to use trapezoidal rule for finding out area under the unit hydrograph. So this is the formula of trapezoidal rule. It is like dividing the area under this curve into equal units, and we are finding out area of individual units. Here delta x is the interval, delta x by 2 f of x0, first q value f of xn, the last q value, then sum of other values multiplied with the 2. So here the interval is given as 1 hour. So in this question, the area under the unit hydrograph will be 1 by 2 into f of x0, it is 0, f of xn is also 0. So 2 into sum of other values, it will be 22. And the area is asked in kilometer square multiplied with 10 power 6 into, since it's a unit hydrograph, 1 centimeter rainfall excess. So by solving this equation, we will get area as 7.92 kilometer square. Any doubt? Sixth question, the triangular direct runoff hydrograph due to a storm has a time base of 60 hours and a peak flow of 30 meter cube per second occurring at 20 hours from the start. If catchment area is 300 kilometer square, what is the rainfall excess? So the options are 50 mm, 20 mm, 10.8 mm and 8.3 mm. So the answer for the sixth question, 10.8 mm. Shall I move to seventh question? Then seventh question, the excess runoff hydrograph from a catchment area of 10 km square due to a storm of 6 hour duration has been observed to be 10 meter cube per second and base length is 20 hours. The rainfall excess in catchment is options 5.1 cm, 3.6 cm, 4.5 cm and 2.5 cm. So the answer for seventh question is 3.6 centimeter. We will see the eighth question. The total observed runoff volume during a 4-hour storm with a uniform intensity of 2.8 cm per hour is 25.2 into 10 power 6 meter cube from a base. Average infiltration rate for the basin. Options are 3.6 mm per hour, 4.8 mm per hour, 5.2 mm per hour and 5.5 mm per hour. So in this question, the volume of runoff is already given, rainfall intensity is given, and the river asked to find out infiltration rate for the basin. So here, the excess rainfall will be like the rainfall intensity is 2.8 cm and is occurring for 4-hour duration. So 2.8 into 4 minus infiltration rate into 4 will be the rainfall excess. And the remaining parameters are given. If we solve for infiltration rate, it will be 0.55 cm per hour. Since the options are given in millimeter per hour, the answer will be 5.5 mm per hour. Any doubt? Ninth question, a 4-hour unit hydrograph of a basin can be approximated as triangle with a base period of 48 hours and a peak coordinate of 300 meters per second. What is the area of the catchment? Options, 7,776 kilometers square, 5,184, 2,592, 1,294. So the answer for ninth question will be 2,592 kilometers square. Shall I proceed to next question? So the next question, a 2-hour storm hydrograph has 5 units of direct runoff. The 2-hour unit hydrograph for the storm can be obtained by dividing the ordinates of the storm hydrograph by options 2, 2 by 5, 5 and 5 by 2. Anybody can answer this question? Answer, please. Okay. No, the answer will be 5 only. See here, 2 hour unit hydrograph is asked from say 2 hour storm hydrograph. So base flow is not given, so we will take the base flow as 0. So if we the storm hydrograph ordinate will be same as direct runoff hydrograph ordinate. The direct runoff hydrograph ordinate divided by rainfall excess or runoff depth will be ordinate of unit hydrograph. So here the runoff depth is given as 5 units. So ordinate of storm hydrograph by 5 will give ordinate of unit hydrograph.
Excuse me.
Tell me.
Ma'am, here that storm hydrograph and the direct runoff hydrograph are same or different?
Storm hydrograph means flood hydrograph only. Flood hydrograph, if you are deducting the base flow component from the flood hydrograph, we will get the direct runoff hydrograph.
Okay. So here you told that from the storm hydro, then how we will calculate, because here the no base flow is given, so how we will calculate the direct runoff hydrograph here to calculate the unit hydrograph of the 2 hour unit?
Since here base flow is not given, we will take it as 0 itself. So ordinate of direct runoff hydrograph and flood hydrograph will be same.
Okay. So if anywhere the base flow is not given, then we can consider base flow as a 0.
If any base flow value is given in the question, we need to deduct that particular value from the ordinate of storm hydrograph, then divide by 5.
Okay, thank you.
Then coming to 11th question. If a 4-hour unit hydrograph of a certain basin has a P coordinate of 80 meter cube per second, the P coordinate of a 2-hour unit hydrograph for the same basin is options 80 meter cube per second, greater than 80 meter cube per second, less than 80 meter cube per second, then 4 to 80 meter cube per second. Anybody can answer. Anyone please answer.
Less than 80.
Okay, see, the P coordinate of 4-hour unit hydrograph is given. Unit hydrograph is nothing but a rainfall excess of 1 centimeter occurring uniformly over the entire catchment area. So if the duration of unit hydrograph is 4 hours, means 1 centimeter in 4 hours. If the duration is 2 hours, means 1 centimeter is occurring within 2 hours. So obviously the peak of a 2 hour hydrograph will be always greater than peak of 4 hour unit hydrograph. So the answer will be greater than 18 meter cube per second. Any doubt?
Ma'am, can you explain this through graph?
Through graph?
Yes.
Here no need of any graph found out. You just, unit hydrograph is nothing but 1 centimeter rainfall excess or 1 centimeter depth of runoff, right?
Yes. Actually, if ma'am, suppose in place of the 2 hour unit hydrograph, if it is asked more than the 4 hour unit hydrograph, then if you will explain through the graph, then it will be the better in understanding whether we can understand whether will be this peak will be the less or high.
Always remember one concept. If the duration of a unit hydrograph is less, its peak will be higher. Means within a short period of time, 1 centimeter runoff is occurring. So if the wherever the duration of the unihydrograph is less, there the peak will be higher. You just remember that concept. So here there is no need of any calculations and all. The options, you just say the options. Greater than 80, less than 80, 4 to 80, 80. Only four options are there. So you, if you know the concept, within second you can find the answer. No need of a graph and all.
Okay, thank you.
Then coming to 12th question. A direct runoff hydrograph due to an isolated storm with an effective rainfall of 2 cm was trapezoidal in shape. The catchment area in kilometer square would be the options 790.2, 599.4, 689.5, then 435.3. So here in this graph, the base period is 70 hours and here it is a trapezoidal in shape and the top width is 4 hours. This is 4 hours. And the peak value is 90. Peak is 90, top width 4 hours. Solve the question.
Options are 59.5.
You see the options 790.2, 599.4, 689.5, 435.3.
See number 659.5.
The answer. Twelfth question. You see here. The top width is given as 4 hours. This is 4 hours. So if we draw a line here, we will get two rectangles under one rectangle under two triangles. So since this is 4 hour, 70 minus 4, 66. So here 66 by 2, 33. And here the base period of the triangle will be 33. Here also the base period of the triangle will be 33. Then another rectangle with the one side 4 and another side 90. So like this, you need to find out the area. If we solve, the answer will be 599.4 kilometer square. Any doubt? The 13th question. A 4-hour unit hydrograph of a catchment is triangular in shape with a base period of 80 hours. The area of the catchment is 720 km square. The base flow and 5 index values are 30 meter cube per second and 1 mm per hour respectively. A storm of 4 cm occurs uniformly in 4 hours over the catchment. First question. Peak discharge of 4-hour unit hydrograph. Options 40 meter cube per second, 50 meter cube per second, 60 meter cube per second, and 70 meter cube per second. Next question. Peak flood discharge due to storm. Options 210, 230, 260 and 720 meter cube per second. We will see the answer. The answer for first question is 50 meter cube per second. Here, four centimeter is the rainfall occurring over the catchment, and phi index value one mm per hour. So for 4 hour duration, it will be 4 mm or 0.4 centimeter. So rainfall excess will be 4 minus 0.4, 3.6 centimeter. Area is given, base period is given, and we need to find out the peak of direct runoff hydrograph from this equation. If we know the peak discharge of direct runoff hydrograph, we can find out the peak of unit hydrograph by dividing the peak of direct runoff hydrograph with the rainfall excess. So the answer will be 50 meter cube per second for the first option. And the second question, peak flood discharge due to storm means the peak value of flood hydrograph, that will be nothing but peak value of direct runoff hydrograph plus base flow. So the answer will be 210 meter cube per second. Any doubt?
No.
Any doubt? Okay, the 14th question. The drainage area of a watershed is 50 kilometers square. The phi index value is 0.5 centimeter per hour, and base flow at the outlet is 10 meter cube per second. The 1 hour unit hydrograph of the watershed is triangular in shape with a time base of 15 hours. The peak ordinate occur at the 5 hour. First question, peak ordinate in meter cube per second per centimeter of the unit hydrograph is options 10, 18.52, 37.03, 185.2. Next question, for a storm of depth 5.5 centimeter and duration 1 hour, the peak ordinate of the hydrograph is options 55, 82.6, 92.6 and 102.6. So you will see the answer. The answer for the first question is 18.52 meter cube per second per centimeter. And the answer for the second question, 92.6 meter cube per second. Any doubt? Shall I proceed to next question? So, the second last question, a unit hydrograph for a watershed is triangular with a base period of 20 hours. The area of the watershed is 500 hectares. What is the peak discharge in meter cube per hour? Options 7,000, 6,000, 5,000 and 4,000. Can anyone answer this question? Yes, correct. We'll move to last question. The ordinates of a 1 hour unit hydrograph at a 60 minutes interval are 0, 3, 12, 8, 6, 3 and 0 meter cube per second. A 2 hour storm of 4 centimeter excess rainfall occurred in the basin from 10 a.m. Considering constant base flow of 20 meter cube per second, the flow of the river at 1 p.m. would be options 56, 72, 60 and 48. Try to solve the question. So, any answer? Anyone got the answer? Pardon? Okay, we will see the answer. So here, the ordinates of a 1 hour unit hydrograph is given, and we were asked to find out the ordinate of flood hydrograph. The flow of the river is nothing but ordinates of flood hydrograph at 1 p.m. So, the first and the second column, it is given in the question. It is starting from 10 a.m. and the values are given at 1 hour interval. So, if we need to find out the values corresponding to 2 hour unit hydrograph, we need to lag these values by 1 hour again. So the third column, it will start from 11 a.m. Then if we sum second and third column, we will get ordinates of hydrograph with the 2 hour duration and the 2 centimeter rainfall excess. From here, we can find out the ordinate of unit hydrograph of 2 hour duration. So the last column that will be obtained by dividing the values of fourth column by 2, because here we are considering 2 unit hydrograph lagged by 1 hour, so 1 centimeter plus 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter will be the rainfall excess. So the peak of this value 10, that will be the we were asked to find out Q value at 1 pm. So for the 2 hour unit hydrograph at 1 pm, discharge is 10 meter cube per second. Then from here, the ordinate of direct runoff hydrograph of 2 hour duration and 4 centimeter rainfall excess will be obtained as 10 into this peak value 10 into rainfall excess 4 centimeter, 40 meter per second. So the ordinate of flood hydrograph or the river flow at the 1 pm will be 40 plus base flow 20, 60 meter per second. Any doubt? Question, let's see, the 2 hour storm of 4 centimeter excess rainfall. It is given in the question itself. 4 centimeter excess rainfall. Okay, so with this, I am concluding today's session. For any further discussion, you can contact me through mail or WhatsApp. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am, for this rightful section. And also thank you for being here today. Thank you, ma'am. Today's section came to an end. Once again, thank you, one and all present here. Now this section is over. Everyone can leave the meeting. Thank you.